Hello. Unit number 4 of integrated circuits is of converters using op-amp, where we'll study V2F converters, I2V converters and V2I converters, various types of DAC, characteristics, specifications, advantages, disadvantages, and same is the case with ADCs also. The first circuit is of V2F converter. The diagram, circuit diagram, is of a combination consisting of inverting integrator and Schmitt trigger, and therefore output has to swing between plus minus Vsat values. If it is assumed that Vo is equal to plus Vsat initially, this voltage will reverse bias diode D1 and integrator capacitor C will get charged through Vin and resistor R. If Vin is also positive, then integrator output will start decreasing linearly as shown in next waveform. As soon as the integrator output reaches to level of VLT, you can see these diagrams, as soon as it reaches to value of VLT of non-inverting Schmitt trigger, output will switch from plus Vsat to minus Vsat. Now the value of integrator output at which this changeover takes place is given by value of VLT, which is nothing but minus R1 by R2 times Vsat. Now, as output is equal to minus Vsat, here diode D1 will be forward biased. Diode D will be forward biased. The capacitor will discharge through D and resistance R3. The integrator output will now increase linearly from minus R1 by R2 into Vsat to R1 by R2 into Vsat as shown in the diagram. The discharging rate of capacitor is much faster than the charging rate, which is due to the small value of R3 as compared to value of R. And as soon as VO dash reaches VUT, the output voltage will switch from minus Vsat to plus Vsat again. And therefore VUT is equal to R1 by R2 times Vsat. Now the discharging time TD is constant as it is dependent only on R3 times C, R3 into C, which is time constant. As charging time is much greater than discharge time, the total time T, and hence the output frequency of FO can be controlled by controlling TC through variation in Vin. And thus we can say that it is voltage to frequency converter. The next circuit is of current to voltage converter, that is I to V converter. Here it is a circuit which is special case of inverting amplifier. The open loop gain AV of op amp is very large. So as per concept of virtual short, we can say that V1 is equal to V2. Input impedance of op amp is again very high, and therefore IB1 has to be equal to IB2, which is equal to 0. Gain of inverting amplifier is given as minus RF by R1, and therefore VO is equal to minus RF by R1 times Vin. But from the concept of virtual short, virtual ground, we can say that V1 is equal to V2 equal to 0, and therefore V2 is also 0, and thus the inverting terminal is also at ground potential, and the entire input waveform, entire input voltage appears across R1 only. And therefore, IN, input current, is equal to Vin upon R1, and Vin is equal to IN times R1. Next voltage is nothing but voltage to current converter with floating load, V2I converter. Now see, let us analyze this circuit. Here, one terminal of the load is connected to, Yeah. Now this is a special type of voltage to current converter with floating load. The load RL is called as a floating load because it is not connected to the ground. Here, the input voltage is applied to non-inverting terminal. Load resistance RL is connected in place of feedback resistance RF. It is also known as current series negative feedback amplifier. Applying KVL to the input loop, we can say that Vin is equal to Vd plus Vf. But as open loop gain of this op amp is very large, Vd is almost equal to 0 and therefore Vin is equal to Vf. But Vin is equal to R1 into output current Io, and therefore Io is equal to Vin upon, yeah, it is Vin upon R1. So voltage to current converter. Now the next circuit is V2I converter using grounded load. Here one of the input terminals are connected to ground. So there are various steps. The first step is we have to calculate value of V1. This is the circuit diagram shown with all the symbols and components. Yeah. So applying KCL at node V1, we can write that IL is equal to I1 plus I2, converting into respective values of V and R, we can say that I1 is equal to V in minus V1 upon R and I2 is equal to VO minus V1 upon R. So putting those values, we can finally get V1 is equal to V in plus VO minus IL into R upon 2. Now we have obtained expression for V1. Now what is the relation of V1 and IL? As op amp is connected in non-inverting mode, voltage gain will be equal to 1 plus R upon R, which is 2, and output voltage is nothing but this gain into V1, which is twice of V1, and substituting those values, we can say that VO is equal to 2 into Vin plus VO minus ILR upon 2. Therefore, if we put all the values, eventually we can get that IL is nothing but Vin upon R. Now about data converters. So the data converters are of two types, DAC and ADC. DAC are classified as binary weighted resistor DAC, R to R ladder network, and ADCs have types of flash type, counter type, dual slope and successive approximation. So the first is binary weighted resistors DAC. So to the inverting terminal, we have connected various resistances through binary weighted resistance brackets. Non-inverting terminal is connected to ground directly. A reference voltage has been applied to MSB, LSB and N-bit digital input signals. So depending on the values 1 and zeros, or reference voltage or zeros, this electronic switch is used to connect value of resistance and voltage. So using these expressions, we can eventually find out value of VO as VR into bracket D1 by 2 plus D2 upon 2 square plus till Dn upon 2 raised to n. Just remember, D1 is MSB and Dn is LSB, which is last bit. So this is typical circuit diagram for 3-bit binary weighted resistance DAC. Potential A is at ground terminal, and using the same formula, we can find out values for output voltage for all the combinations also, from all zeros to all ones, like this. So for all zeros, value will be 0. For 001 combination, value will be VR by 8. For 010, it will be 2 VR by 8. And till last input signal, that is 111, it will be 7 VR by 8. Now, simple circuitry, easy calculation are the advantages. Accuracy and stability are the problems. And wide range of resistance values are required. Resolution is also poor. These are disadvantages. Now, the next famous type of ladder network is R2R ladder network, where the combination or values of resistances are nothing but R and 2R. Remaining all the circuitry remains same. So if we keep on solving these examples or resistance bracket, we eventually come to this simple network, which is minus VR by 4, a single normal resistance Rn and 2R in its feedback loop. Now it is a simple comparison of all the types of DACs which we have seen. Resolution, accuracy, linearity, temperature sensitivity, these are specifications. Linearity, offset, gain, these are special source errors in DAC. So linearity is nothing but the amount by which actual output of DAC is differing from the ideal value. Offset error is nothing but if all inputs are zero, analog output is also expected to be zero, but practically it does not happen. Some non-zero analog voltage exists. So this is offset error. Gain error is defined as difference between calculated gain and practically obtained gain value. So due to resistor value error, this error may exist. ADCs are classified as flash type, counter type, dual slope, successive approximation. So this is circuit diagram, typical circuit diagram for 2-bit flash type ADC. Analog input is given to all the non-inverting terminals, and inverting terminals are given stage-wise input as VR upon 4, 2 VR upon 4 and 3 VR upon 4, whereas VR is a reference voltage, and output of all the comparators are given to priority encoder. Priority encoder is nothing but it is going to be a digital valued output. So V1 will be VR by 4, V2 will be VR by 2 and V3 will be V3 VR by 4. So if analog input is between 0 to VR by 4, output will be 0. If it is between VR by 4 to VR by 2, output will be 0, 1. Between 2 VR by 4 to 3 VR by 4, it will be 1, 0. And for last, 3 VR by 4 to reference value VR, it will be 1, 1, 2. So eventually within these 4 steps, we have calculated or we have divided the output range. Using similar approximation, this is the circuit diagram and output table for 3-bit flash type ADC. These are advantages and disadvantages. A counter type ADC, so a clock is used, binary counter is given, comparator is there. So DAC output is given to inverting terminal, non-inverting terminal is nothing but your analog input voltage. These are its advantages and disadvantages. Construction wise, it is simple. Speed can be adjusted using clock frequency faster than dual slope ADC. So this is successive approximation type ADC, a famous one. So analog input is given to comparators, non-inverting terminal. Inverting terminal has DAC output VD, so it will be compared and it will be fed to SAR. and depending on the error values or SAR values, output will be observed like this. So initially all values will be 0, SAR output when difference is 0, comparator output will be 1, D1 is 1, remaining all will be 0, and eventually after successive comparisons, yes, we can get final output. So every time value of VD and VA will be compared. So if VD is less than VA, comparator output will be 1. If it is greater than VA, it will be 0 output. So successive approximations like this. We are dealing with SAR output and comparator's output. And the final one is dual slope ADC. So integrator and comparator, those are cascaded. Input will be given through switches, ground and minus V reference values. Control logic, that is SOC, EOC. Counter is given. These are waveforms for dual slope ADC. Thank you.